Greetings. In some of our further sessions, we are going to discuss about the lateral dynamics of vehicles.
So, our COEs analyze the vehicle handling characteristics based on lateral dynamics.
In our future sessions of lateral dynamics, what we are going to discuss is steering geometry. One. Second, steering handling characteristics, that is understeer, oversteer and neutral steer conditions. Our third one, lateral acceleration response. Fourth content is yaw velocity response. Fifth one, curvature response. Fifth content is testing of vehicle, that is constant radius test, constant speed test and constant steering angle test.
Last but not least,
our last content is influence of suspension system on cornering of vehicle. In our today's session,
our learning objectives are
build a dynamic model of your car using kinematic bicycle model as a starting point. Second one, convert to standard state space representation.
As you know that lateral systems are under commercial development because lane deposits are the number one cause of fatal accidents in the world and account for more than 40% of crash-related fatalities. Reports by the National Highway Transportation Safety Administration state
as many as 1,15,75,000 accidents annually are caused by distracted drivers, a large percentage of which can be attributed to unintended lane departures.
And lane departures are also identified as a major cause of rollover accidents involving sport utility vehicles and light trucks.
So, there are three types of lateral systems have been developed in automotive industry that address lane departure accidents. Those systems are lane departure warning systems, LDWS, lane keeping systems, LKS, and yaw stability control systems, YSC.
A significant amount of research is also being conducted by university researchers on this type of systems. Anyway, we are not going to discuss about LDWS, LKS, OSG of lateral systems here. If you want to know about these systems, you can just Google it and can get more informations, right? But here we are just going to discuss about the handling behavior of vehicle under certain conditions. So, the cornering behavior of a motor vehicle is an important performance mode often equated with handling. Right? Handling is just a word of loosely used term meant to imply the response of vehicle to input given by driver. Right? It is a combination of vehicle and driver.
Actually, in Portugal, what is happening here is the driver giving input, the vehicle will respond according to the input given by the driver, and the driver can change the input according to the response getting from the vehicle, right? This is a closed loop system.
But actually here in lateral dynamics, what we are going to develop is an open loop systems, right? Like driver is going to give input, the vehicle will respond. There is no alter in the given input, right? According to the input given,
how the vehicle is going to behave. That is what we are going to discuss in certain conditions. Most commonly used measure of open loop response is the understeer gradient. The understeer gradient is a measure of performance under steady state conditions, although the measure can be used to info the performance properties under conditions that are not quasi steady state. So here, in open loop cornering, our directional response behavior is going to examined in this section. In open loop cornering is going to examine in this session. So the approach is to first analyze the turning behavior at low speed. After that,
under higher speeds, the importance of type properties will appear in high speed cornering case and provide a natural point for a systematic study of suspension properties influencing the turning, right? Under certain conditions or assumptions, a kinematic model for the lateral motion of a vehicle can be developed. Such a model provides a mathematical description of vehicle motion without considering the forces that affect the motion of vehicle. The equations of motions are based purely on the geometric relationship of governing the system. So, consider a bicycle model of vehicle as shown in this figure. In this model, the front, left and right tires are combined together and make it as a lumped mass as a front wheel. As similar, the rear left and right wheels are combined together and make it as a rear wheel. So here the four wheel is converted as a two wheeled vehicle. So here in this bicycle model, while cornering, the front wheels develops the angle of del F and rear wheel develops an angle of del R in two wheel, that is a front and rear wheel steering systems. Okay, let us develop a geometric relationship between these two wheels, right? Okay, so as we know that the total length of vehicle, that is a wheelbase of vehicle, can be indicated as L caps. Okay, we are here just to develop a geometric relationship between the wheels, right? Okay, so here we are going to draw a line of these wheels perpendicular to the motion of wheel, right? Just to draw a perpendicular line to rear wheel motion, right? So perpendicular line for this line is maybe like this, and your front wheel center line, perpendicular line may be like this. These two lines meet at the point O. I just draw here. You can see the perpendicular line of front wheel like this, and perpendicular line of rear wheel like this, and these two lines meet at point O. So I hope you can understand the perpendicular line concept. The perpendicular line for center line of wheel, so for rear wheel, and this is perpendicular line of front wheel center line like this. So we just made a point of center of gravity CG from the distance of front wheel to CG point can be indicated as LF caps are small, and rear to center of gravity distance may be indicated as LR. We just indicated in small letter, small LF and small LR, right? So just to draw a line from point O to CG. So this is the radius of curvature R. I just draw here. We can call it as a R, turning radius of vehicle,
right? Okay. We have to make an angle of this triangle, right? So this is a perpendicular line. So between the perpendicular line, the angle may be 90 degree. 90 degree can be mentioned as 5/2. So the total angle between this line, the vehicle forwarding direction, so here to here may be 5/2 plus del f. So here the angle between this line may be 5/2 minus del f, right? So I repeat, this is del f. So you get here 90 degree. Here 90 degree, 90 degree is 5/2. So the total angle between this line, this to this, may be 5/2 plus del f. So here the total angle between these two line, 5/2 minus del f. So here this is vehicle direction v. So the angle between the vehicle direction and this one may be indicated as beta. So here you can get an angle of, so just think like del f minus beta, right? Let us come to this point. So this one del r, right? So it makes 90 degree. So the angle, this is 90 degree between these two lines. So the total angle between these two lines are del r plus 5/2, right? Okay. So here the angle may be, think, okay, so here the angle is beta minus del r. So here we just develop the geometric relationship of two-wheeled vehicle. For a good vision of a bicycle model, I just redraw this picture. Here the vehicle moves along the direction it makes, the follow of vehicle will be in this direction. It is indicated in dotted line. If you make a cornering or turning, front wheels creates del f and rear wheels creates del r. Here the point A and point B are indicated the right and left tires. A indicator right combination of right and left tires of front, and B indicator the right and left tire combinations of rear. The distance between A and B point, we know that wheelbase commonly indicated as caps L, right? Okay. We know the center of gravity point from the distance of front axial to center of gravity, LF. Rear axial to center of gravity may be indicated as LR. To make this bicycle model, this is the center plane or center line of rear tire. This is the center line of front tires, right? Okay. I just draw a perpendicular line to the center line of rear like this, and perpendicular line to front tire center line is like this, right? So these two perpendicular lines meet at a single point, it may be marked as O, right? So we just draw a line from O to center of gravity, that has our distance of R. This is a radius of turning or turning radius, whatever it may be indicated. So at the starting, the vehicle moves in this direction that is marked as dotted, right? So after turning, the vehicle will move like this. So from the wheelbase line, the vehicle creates beta angle here to wheelbase to dotted line, it makes psi angle. Here del F, here del R.
Have a keen listening here, right? So the central line of wheel and the perpendicular line makes 90 degrees. So the angle between this line to here, it makes 5/2 + del F. So here to here 180 degrees, that is 5. So the angle between the wheelbase and this perpendicular line is 5/2 - del F, right? This is 5, this one 5/2 + del F. So here 5/2 - del F, right? As similar as front, the rear makes del R angle, steering angle, right? Okay. So the perpendicular to center line is 5/2. So here to here 5/2 + del R. Sorry. Right? Okay. So this triangle makes 5/2 - del F. So here you can see del F minus beta, because the vehicle makes beta angle with wheel base. So here you get del F minus beta, right? Here it makes beta angle, it does 5/2 + del R. So here you can get beta minus del R. As I told earlier, the model provides a mathematical description of vehicle motion without considering the forces that affect its motion. There is no forces considered here, right? The equations are based on geometric relationship of governing these systems. The relationships only governing this vehicle system here. So here the vehicle has a planar motion, right? We just assume like that, right? Okay. There are three coordinates are required to describe the motion of this vehicle. First coordinate is X, second coordinate is Y, and third initial coordinates, which describes the orientation of vehicle, that is psi. The velocity at the CG of the vehicle is denoted as V, and maximum angle of beta with longitudinal axis or wheelbase of vehicle. This beta is generally called as slip angle of vehicle. There are number of assumptions we are going to make here. So our assumption starts with the development of kinetic model is the velocity vectors at point A and point B are in the direction of orientation of the front and rear wheels respectively, right? In other words, the velocity vector at the front wheels makes an del F with longitudinal axis of vehicle. There is no slip angle here and here, we just assume like that, but according to our discussion in tire dynamics, there will be slip in front or rear tires, right? There will be a slip angle in tires, but for our problem we just assume there is no slip angle, which means slip angle is equal to zero, right? This is a reasonable assumption for low speed turning. For low speed turning, there is no slip angle. Suppose if we go for high speed turning, there will be slip angle, right? At low speeds, the lateral force developed at the tires or wherever it may be is very small, right? In order to drive any circular roads of radius r, the total lateral force from the both tires is mv squared divided by r. You know that m is mass of vehicle, v velocity of vehicle, r that is making
radius of CG to O point. O is the imaginary point, like. So the force varies quadratically with the speed V and is small at low speeds, right? When the lateral forces are small, I repeat, it is very reasonable to assume that the velocity of each front and rear wheels, whatever, is in the direction of the wheel. Here, the point O is an instantaneous rolling center of the vehicle. The point O is defined by the intersection of OA and OB lines, which are drawn perpendicular to the orientation of two rolling wheels. The length or the radius of the vehicle's path R is defined by the length of line O to CG, right, which connects the center of gravity to the instantaneous rolling center. The angle psi is generally called as heading angle of the vehicle. The course angle for the vehicle is, we can calculate as R or gamma, whatever. So psi plus beta, because beta is the angle made by vehicle and psi is a heading angle. So the course angle is combination of beta plus psi. Now we apply the sine rule to the O, CG, or maybe C indicated. So OCA triangle, right? If we take OCA triangle, so we know that sine theta equal to opposite divided by hypotenuse, right? Okay. So OCA, for OCA triangle, so sine del F minus beta equal to LF divided by hypotenuse, maybe HP, maybe, right? So 1 by hype equal to sin del F minus beta divided by LF. This is our first equation. Okay, so as well as we take the triangle of OCB, so if we take OCB triangle similar to that for triangle OCB, so 1 by hype equal to sine beta minus del R divided by L R, right? This is our equation 2. Okay, come again to OCA triangle. Using this angle 5 by 2 minus del F, so that which is 1 by hype, which is equal to sine 5 by 2 minus del F divided by R. So come again to OCB triangle, 1 by H hypotenuse equal to sine 5 by 2 plus del R divided by R, right? So I rewrite our 1 and 2 equations. So first equations become sine del F minus beta, L F minus beta divided by L F equal to sine phi by 2 minus del f divided by r. So I indicated as 1a. So our second equation becomes, second equation is sine phi by 2 plus del r divided by r equal to, you can rewrite whatever, sine beta minus del r divided by l r. So this is our 2a. You know the true meaning of sine a minus b. So sine a minus b equal to sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. So use this format, we apply in our equation 1a and 2a, sine del f minus b instead of del f we have a, instead of beta we have b, here sine beta minus del r, instead of a we have beta, instead of b we have del r. So our 1a equation becomes 1a cos beta minus sine beta cos del f divided by l f, which is equal to cos del f divided by r. This is our equation 3. Equation 2a becomes, equation 2a is sine phi by 2 plus del r divided by r equal to sine beta minus del r divided by l r. So beta is, maybe we have a, instead of del r we have b. So sine beta minus del r becomes sine a sine beta cos del r minus cos beta sine del r divided by l r, which is equal to, here sine phi by 2 del r sine phi by 2 plus del r divided by r. This is our equation 4. You know that sine phi by 2 plus del f, sorry, sine phi by 2 plus del r maybe becomes, maybe it becomes cos del r. Anything, sine 90 plus theta sine theta, sine phi by 2 plus theta cos theta. Likewise, sine phi by 2 minus theta cos theta. So our equation number 3 is sine del f cos beta minus sine beta cos del f divided by l f equal to cos del f by r. Equation number 3. And 2a becomes sine beta cos del r minus cos beta sine del r divided by l r equal to sine phi by 2 divided by del r equal to r. This thing becomes cos del r. For simplifying our equation, we just multiply l f divided by cos del f in both sides of equation number 3. So multiplying both sides with l f divided by cos del f, our equation number 3 becomes see here l f strikeouts. So sine del f cos beta divided by cos del f, so we can write as tan del f cos beta minus sin beta cos del f divided by cos del f. So cos del f can be striked out. So sin beta equal to
cos del f may be crossed out. So lf divided by r. This is our equation number 5. So we follow the same method to equation number 4. So equation number 4 multiplied with lr divided by cos del r. So that equation becomes sin beta minus tan del r cos beta equal to lr by r. You can make it like this and make a strike out. So we can get the equation 6 because of multiplying the equation number 4 with lr divided by cos del r. And adding the equation number 5 and 6, 5 plus 6, which results tan del f cos beta minus sin beta, this is our equation number 5, plus sin beta minus tan del r cos beta, which is equal to lf by r plus lr divided by r. So sin minus sin beta plus sin beta becomes 0. So tan del f cos beta minus tan del r cos beta equal to lf the lf plus lr divided by r. So we can take cos beta out as tan del r into cos beta equal to lf plus lr divided by r. This is our equation number 7. If we assume that
the radius of vehicle path changes slowly due to the low vehicle speed, then the rate of change of orientation of vehicle must be equal to the angular velocity of the vehicle, since the angular velocity of vehicle is we know that v by r. It follows that
psi dot equal to v divided by r, right? This is our equation number 8. Equations 7 and 8 written as psi dot equal to v cos beta divided by lf plus lr. So lr into tan del f minus tan del r, because psi equal to v by r. This is our equation number 9. So the overall equations of motions x dot equal to v into, we know that cos of psi plus beta, this is a cos angular. So y dot equal to v of sin psi plus beta, this is our equation 10, this one 11. So the overall velocities of vehicle, psi dot, x dot, y dot, this is our coordinates x, y and initial coordinates psi. In this model you get there are 3 inputs, that is our steering angle of front wheels, del f, steering angle of rear wheel del R and the vehicle velocity V. The velocity is a external variable and can be assumed to be a time varying function or can be obtained from the longitudinal vehicle model, right? The slip angle beta can be obtained by multiplying equation 5 with LR and subtracting it equation 6 multiplied by LF. So I repeat, the slip angle beta can be obtained by multiplying the equation number 5. This is our equation number 5. Multiplying by LR and subtracting it with the equation number 6, which is multiplied by LF, right? So if we multiply LR in this equation, this is our equation number 5, so it becomes tan del F cos beta minus sin beta equal to LF LR divided by R. So here sin beta minus tan del R cos beta equal to LF LR by R, right? Sorry, I forgot to write here LR, here LF because of multiplication LF, right? Okay, so here you get LF LR divided by R, here to LF LR by R. So these two equations are equal. So LR into tan del F cos beta minus sin beta equal to LF into sin beta minus tan del R cos beta. Right, so we just multiplying here LR tan del F cos beta minus LR sin beta, which is equal to LF sin beta minus LF tan del R cos beta. We just bring here. So LR tan del F cos beta minus LR sin beta minus LF sin beta plus LF tan del R cos beta equal to 0. So simplify the previous equations, we get beta equal to tan inverse of LF tan del R plus LR tan del F divided by LF plus LR. This is our beta, this is a slip angle of vehicle, right? This is our equation number 12. There is a remark in our assumption that is appropriate to include a note on the bicycle model assumption. Both the left and right front wheels are represented by one wheel in bicycle model. It should be noted that the left and right steering angles in general will be approximately equal, but not exactly equal. We just mentioned as del F that is not equal at front right and left wheels. There may be some difference in steering angles, right? So this is because of the radius of path each of these wheels travels is different. Consider a front wheel steered vehicles as shown in figure. That I hope you know the Occam's steering geometry. So these two wheels are left and right wheels of front axle. This is the left and right wheels of rear axle. So just integrate as front as F, rear as R, right? So the front inner wheel makes del I angle, front outer wheel makes del not angle. These two angles is not same, right? So we just draw a perpendicular line to the center line of wheel, this one, and this is center line of wheel of outer wheel, del not, right? So it meets at a point. Whoa, we just draw a line of center rear axle straight line. So these three lines meet, these three lines meet at point O, and from point O we make a line with CG, that is a radius of turning R, right? So from this geometry we just take it as inner and outer wheels are not makes equal angle. Let us take T as a track width of vehicle and L is the wheel base, del not steering angle of outer wheel and del I steering angle of inner wheels. So we know the length of CG to front axle LF, and this one CG to rear axle LR. Repeat. Psi dot divided by V approximately equal to 1 by R, which is equal to del by L. So T is track width and L is wheel base, LF length between front axle to center of gravity, and LR is distance between center of gravity to rear axle. So we take a front outer wheel A, front inner wheel B, rear right wheel D, and rear left wheel C. We take a triangle AOC. AOC makes an angle of del naught. So tan del naught equal to opposite side. Opposite is L. So opposite divided by adjacent. Adjacent we have R turning radius. Here the track width is T. So R plus T by 2 for adjacent. So here to here R, we just assume that. So here to here T by 2, we know that. So 10 del not equal to L by R plus T by 2. As similar as 10 del I, take a triangle of inner wheels. So here B O D, so which makes an angle of del I. So opposite side is L length, adjacent side is here to here R distance. So the point or center wheel point of right wheel to O point, the distance is R minus T by 2. So tan del I equal to L by R minus T by 2. So this is the angle of del naught and del I are very very small. So del naught equal to L by R plus T by 2, similar to del I equal to L by R minus T by 2. So the total steering angle del equal to L by R. We just take an average, right? This comes as del naught plus del I by 2, right? Okay. The difference between del I minus del naught equal to L by R squared into T by, L divided by R squared into T, right? Which is equal to del squared T divided by L. Right. Here I just summarized what we have calculated till now. X global axis in x coordinate, x dot equal to v cos phi plus beta. Y global axis in y coordinate system, y dot equal to v sin psi plus beta. And psi
या एंगल विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू एक्स एक्सिस साइड डॉट इक्वल टू वी कॉस बीटा डिवाइड बाई एल एफ प्लस एल आर इंटू टेन सॉरी यूज अ ब्रैकेट इंटू टेन डेल एफ माइनस टेल आर टेन डेल आर ब्रैकेट क्लोज्ड एंड बीटा दिस इज अ व्हीकल स्लिप एंगल बीटा इक्वल टू टर्न इनवर्स ऑफ एल एफ टर्न डेल आर जस्ट क्लियरली इंडिकेट हियर एल एफ टर्न डेल आर प्लस एल आर टर्न डेल एफ होल डिवाइड बाई एल एफ प्लस एल आर आई रिपीट वॉट वी हैव कैलकुलेटर हियर इज फॉर लो स्पीड टर्निंग ऑफ व्हीकल बिकॉज वी डिडंट इंक्लूड एनी स्लिप एंगल हियर ई मीन एनी स्लिप एंगल ऑफ टायर इज इंक्लूडेड हियर इज जीरो We didn't include any tire slip angle. We just calculate the vehicle slip angle, right? So this is for low speed turning. We have to calculate the vehicle in high speed turning. There you have to include tire slip angle too. Okay, thank you.